But at the very beginning, when did you fall in love with dance?
No. Dance was by force.
Yeah.
So I have one of those moms that there's no such thing as watching TV.
Yeah.
There's no such thing as playing, okay, I'm going to show my age now, but Game Boy.
Yeah.
Like, that thing didn't exist. My mom was like, every activity under the sun,
yeah,
you will experience. I did hockey, mm-hmm, I did karate, I did clay pigeon shooting, I did like, there is
what?
Nothing.
Yeah. Hold on. Clay pigeon shooting.
Yeah.
That is what, you know, in Kenya we call it fair. That's when you go out with a fair and then you start hunting flying rats. You know, a pigeon is a flying rat.
With a stone.
But in the UK you call it?
Clay pigeon shooting.
Yeah. Yeah, that's softies.
Trust me.
Can you imagine hitting a pigeon?
No, it's not a real thing. It's clay. It's clay.
I was
shoot
real.
Clay in the air, and you're supposed to shoot the clay.
Ours was real, but
was like real.
You're like
shooting down pigeons.
Anything that was flying was
something
shot
called, something called a fair.
Yeah.
A catapult.
No, ours was a gun.
That's not a fair.
Yeah. We had a gun.
That's being about a fair.
I'll ask him. No.
Okay.
So my mom forced me into everything. So it came to a certain point where she was just like, let's try you with ballet.
Okay.
I had one of those schedules where Monday you do this, Tuesday you do this.
My mom was focused.
My mom was focused to the max. So I started with ballet, and if I'm being honest, I didn't love it.
Yeah.
But I was very good at it. Mm-hmm. And I think as a kid, if you're getting praise all the time,
you just
start to kind of like it.
Yeah.
So I did all my exams.
Hold on.
Exams.
Like theory or practical?
Both. You know when you do, okay, so most people don't know that written music,
uh-huh,
everyone knows that. Mm-hmm. We have that in dance. It's called Laban notation.
Mm-hmm.
You actually get sheet work.
Okay.
Wow.
Mm. Hey.
So you did all the exams?
I did all the exams. Tap, ballet, disco.
Mm-hmm.
Ballet I was really good at. They had hired a teacher to mm-hmm come from Russia, and they used to have an hour out of school
mm-hmm
where they used to train me on my toe, point work it's called.
And that's the thing Matiangi burnt.
Yes.
Tuition.
Okay.
Holiday tuition.
But this is after school activities.
Matiangi does not allow that.
No.
Don't carry your work home.
Because Chiki, don't believe him. Don't.
I don't. Shafi.
Anyway.
So, you know, I was taking it quite seriously, partly by force,
yeah,
but, you know, partly because I was good at it. And then puberty hit and bam, hips came. Bam. And ballet doesn't really allow for that. So I remember the instructor being a bit like, you have to be tiny.
Tiny. Yeah.
And I remember the instructor being a bit like to my mom, what do we do?
The hips are here.
They're not going.
Hips don't lie. Hips don't lie. Chiki can't dance ballet.
People can't lift her. So like, it was actually quite an emotional moment in my life when I realized that, okay, let me just finish. And then around about the same time, okay, my mom was also very strict on hip hop and dancehall could not be played in our house.
Okay.
She didn't like the messages.
Mm-hmm.
So I started listening to dancehall and I'm just ratchet to the bone. It doesn't matter how hard my mom tried to put me in one direction. Me, I ran in the other direction. Mm-hmm. So I just fell in love with dancehall. So I used to sneak into my room and listen to the songs, Vibes Cartel, you know, the T.O.K.
Yeah.
Back in the day songs. And then my mom used to always let me go clubbing.
Yeah.
In England, we have under 18 clubs, which are very highly monitored.
Mm-hmm. We have, yeah, also. It's called Jam Session.
Okay. But it's not monitored. But continue.
But ours is heavily monitored. I mean, there are police everywhere
mm-hmm
from 14 to 18.
Yeah.
So I started going to those. But I lived in about half an hour away from a Jamaican area.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I'd leave my area. My mom thought I was going to the ones in our area. We were in a very safe area.
Yeah.
But I'd just go my half an hour down the road and I'd be with Jamaicans. And I guess that's where I learned. So then mm-hmm I started going to dancehall classes. Then I started competing. Then I started performing. And then I just found that was something I was good at. That was something that I loved.
Yeah. Okay. So and today is about with Adele Onyango Shafi, where we have Chiki Kuruka live on with a big announcement. Tell us.
Okay, the way you've made this sound now, I feel under pressure to sing or like something. No. So I'm for a long time, people have been asking, where can they access me?
Mm-hmm.
Some for good reasons.
I'm like, yo, Timofisi, come closer.
Shafi's face was just like, so people have been asking where they can access dance sessions.
No, access you. Let's continue.
Access my dance sessions, because I have a particular way of moving.
No.
Oh my God, I feel like I'm digging myself a bigger grave. Dancing. I have a particular way of dancing. So I've always not been able to commit to anything.
Yeah.
Mainly because, first of all, as an instructor, it doesn't look so good, especially if you're on TV mm-hmm. every single day, to be going from studio to studio to studio. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've had embarrassing incidents where I've hired a studio and then maybe four times the amount of people that can fit into that studio turn up.
Yeah.
So I'm now have a base. I now have a home on Ngong Road, at the top of Ngong Road, mm-hmm. Where all day, every single day, we'll be teaching dance sessions. We have
Ngong
specialists.
Road, my dear, Ngong Road is so huge.
Where opposite Ngong Talisman. Mm-hmm. So the Karen sides of Ngong Road.
Yes, yeah.
But I don't like saying Karen, because
hold on. So that means you have to go like into the Ngong Racecourse.
You go past, and then the roundabout.
The police station.
You pass the current police station. There's a bit of a hill, right?
You go up the hill.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We'll be having classes all day, every single day, mm-hmm. And different styles. So we have twerking, we have hip hop. Yeah, damn right.
Yeah,
we have hip hop. We have Afro. We have dancehall. Mm-hmm. We have Lingala. We have Bongo. Mm-hmm. We have everything.